Nell?
Daddy.
Honey, are you okay? What time is it?
Do you remember the bent neck lady?
Yes.
It was like a bent neck lady.
She's back.
I can't talk or move my arms or legs. I usually start to panic and my breath gets fast and heavy. My heart feels like it's pounding out of my chest.
How long had it been since you'd seen her, I mean?
It's been almost 2 years. I actually hadn't seen her since.
Do you drink coffee?
Are you asking me if I want to get coffee? Well, since Arthur and I met, I started seeing her when I was a kid. All the time when I was a kid. And after the house, when we lived with my aunt, I saw her some more. A few times in high school. In college. After. But then he came into my life and she went away. And then she killed him.
It was a random tragic event.
I know it looked like an aneurysm.
It's perfectly normal to want to find something to blame.
I know what's to blame. I don't expect you to believe me. He was dead. He was dead and she was back. I told you the root of my problems.
Hill House.
Hill House. That's right.
How can a house, just a collection of bricks, wood, and glass, have that much power over people?
My family is just like any other family. We don't always agree on
it. We're not, though. Like any other family. We're different because of where we grew up.
Stop!
What are you doing?
They say she's a nightmare, but she's real.
I know she is. I got an idea. You need 7, and you set them up like this.
Why 7?
Mom, Dad, Stephen, Cheryl, Theo, you, me. It has to be 7. It helps if you touch each one and count out loud.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
That keeps you safe.
Don't do that ever again. Don't do that ever again. Ever. I thought the health things had got you. I thought they took you.
I'm so glad you're okay.
Now you stand there and you talk about ghosts and spirits. And you sell tickets for the privilege, and yet you don't believe in any of it.
How is this new medication working for you? Any issues?
It's great.
Are you off your meds?
No. Yes, I'm taking my meds.
What if I have a worse dream?
Mommy.
What if I dream that you kill us?
It's time to wake up, sweetheart.
What if I dream that you sent us away into the dark and we get hurt?
Really hurt?
You send us away out into the dark and my heart breaks right in half and I can't feel anything happy for weeks and months and years until I can't stand it anymore and I have to die.
How are you gonna put this off, Nellie? And you tell me I'm crazy and that Mom was crazy and Luke's crazy and we're all just nuts. And then you tell our stories, my stories, the same stories that you told me were just dreams or delusions.
You send us out there into the dark, and the dark gets us. A piece at a time, over years and years and years, until I'm on a silver table. It's my jaw wired shut. And it was you that killed us, because you sent us out there, in the night, in the dark.
I
Nell's dead.
And you're supposed to be my big brother. You know, you're supposed to protect me.
I told you she was in trouble. I told you to find her. I told you.
But you say the meanest things to me when I try to tell you.
Let you go again. Never again. I promise.
It was right here. I didn't go anywhere.
I touched her. And I felt...
It was right here.
Nothing. Just nothing.
I was right here. The whole time. None of you could see me. Nobody could see me.
I thought for so long that Don... It was like a line, that our moments were laid out like dominoes and that they fell one into another. And on it went, just days tipping one into the next, in a long line between the beginning and the end. But I was wrong. It's not like that at all. Our moments fall around us like rain or snow or confetti.